Hey guys, Frank here, your virtual general aviation aviator, and today I am in Microsoft Flight Sim, and I think I'm going to take a flight from RDU to Charlotte in the TBM930. Now, this is a flight that I have tried to do more than once. I got this livery that I don't like, so I am going to change the livery. Anyway, so this is a flight that I've tried more than once and have always been unsuccessful at it. Now, as for liveries, I am basically, how shall I say, a pretty conservative guy. So this livery, a paint job, is just too bold for me. This Aviator's Club livery looks pretty conservative. So let's try it. Okay, weight and balance. Let's see, gallons, yes, and left, right, half a tank, 73 gallons. That should get me to Charlotte, okay. For passenger and co-pilot, I guess we'll get another passenger for the front left, and we'll put a passenger in the back there. Okay. And for rear baggage, I guess we'll throw in, 100 pounds? 120 pounds. Let's see what that does to our CG. And we're just about at our alpha limit, but we should be okay. All right, so we've got a max payload here of 795 pounds. We got a payload of 795 pounds and a max payload of 1,787 pounds. Okay. For the TBM, well, for Microsoft Flight Sim, I tend to use November 175 Foxtrot Whiskey because it does not allow me to, what happened to it? November 175 Foxtrot Whiskey. Okay, because it doesn't allow me to set up a call sign for each plane. Looks like it allows only a global call sign. Okay. So we got our aircraft selected, and I think that's going to work. All right, so we're going to start out at Raleigh-Durham, and let's turn that off for right now. My robot mate wants to work right around me. Out of all this house, it want to pick where I'm at to work. Can you believe it? All right, and we're gonna start off on parking. And I guess we'll take parking ramp. It doesn't make any difference. I'm just gonna pick one, 55. Nah, I don't like that one. We'll take that one. Well, which one do we want? Set as departure. Okay, so parking ramp 80. Yeah, that's fine. That's right there. That should be right there at TAC L. And we're going to Charlotte. And Charlotte does not have, Charlotte is not memorized. You know, when I first started using Microsoft Flight Sim, whatever I put in here, my history would change. Now my history is static. it never changes, and I don't know why. If you guys know, then leave it in the comments on how to fix that so that my history will become dynamic and change based on the recent aircraft that I've flown, or maybe even the aircraft that I fly the most. All right, I mean, not the aircraft, but the airports that I frequent the most. Okay, so Charlotte is our destination, and you know, when I get to Charlotte, I desperately would like to go to the FBO, which is actually I can. Okay, so yeah, let's go here to ramp 66. That's my arrival, and we are going to go VOR to VOR. So this should be, is this Sand Hills. I can't read that. Can't read it, but there is another VRR called Liberty. Let's see if, now, wonder if I can change that. And I don't need this VRR here. All right, so maybe I can put in a flight plan from the cockpit, but just in case I can't, I am gonna leave that there. And I'll leave this flight plan here. Okay. And am I forgetting anything? Flight conditions, we want all players, live traffic, and weather and time is live. And that looks about right. It is morning. And let's go with it. All right, so how do I go back? All right, so I want to get out of here now. There we go. And we'll go with fly. All right, so we are getting there. So let's let that load up. Okay, so we are loaded up, and all we need to do is get the aircraft started. Let's see. I think I remember the starting sequence. Now, one thing that I did notice with this aircraft, two things. Number one, I am not that good with the G3000. So there will be a lot of stuff that will slip by me because operating the G3000 is just not in my cup of tea. Number two is once I zoom in, I am unable to figure out how to zoom out. And I'm sure that at some point I will zoom in. So I'll be using the hat button a lot. Number three is the hat button is really hard for me to use. So I can pointed in certain directions and it may or may not move around. And number four, I haven't been able to turn the pitot heat off and on. I almost said PTOC. But I think everything else worked. And number five, let's go ahead and use the ATC, the in-game ATC. I know some of you guys don't like using the word game with the flight simulator, but when it comes to Microsoft, then I think game is appropriate. All right, so let's, our crash bar is up. So let's turn our battery on. We're not gonna use a checklist. I think there is a checklist available. Um, Yeah, there is. But we're not going to use it because it would probably add an hour or so to the flight. All right. So let's do what we normally do. Let's check our fuel. Make sure we got our fuel turned on and off and right and left. Okay, so we'll start on a left tank. After we look at our fuel levels, and I don't see fuel there, so let's go ahead and start this guy. We'll move this out the way for right now. And let's see, how do I now I just zoomed in, and I, like I said, I don't know how to zoom out, and this is blurry. Yeah, let me see if I can't fix the blurriness. So what I did was I changed the refresh rate. I don't think that really had the cockpit glass refresh rate. I don't think that really changed anything. But all of this is why I don't really fly the simulator that much. All right. So I do want to zoom in on the PDF here. And so, and I thought my hat button at one point was allowing me to do so, but not anymore. All right. So anyway, that says part break. That says, I think that says probes. Fuel pressure. So anyway, we're gonna wing it. All right, oil pressure is not up, but the turbines have not started. All right, so let's see what we can do to get started here. And the multifunction display button is here, and flight plan. All right, so we want to add our origin, which would be K R D U. Now this should already be in here. I thought I started it already in her. And then in root, let's see what this says. Let's see, down. All right, I don't know, what does this say? Destination Charlotte. Okay, so it does have my destination in RDU, and I'm not sure where that's. I think that's the waypoint. I think that's the correct waypoint. Yeah, so I think my flight I think it did pick up my flight plan from the previous screen. All right, so we're good there. All right, so let's go back to the PDF and let's get a squawk code. Let's get a squawk code. All right, so we'll go to clearance delivery, and let's get my squawk code from here. Multifunction display, timers, minimal settings, wind back. We turn the wind on option 3. That's always helpful. And let's go home. And see, I'm not sure how to get a squat coat. PDF settings. That's Barron's spec. Traffic. OBS. So as you can see, guys, excuse me. As you can see, guys, I am totally lost in this simulator with the G. Well, this is not the simulator. This is the G3000, and it's just foreign to me. So this has very little to do with the G3000. It's the user in this case. All right, so let's start the aircraft up. I'm sitting here letting it chew on my battery. All right, let's see. So I don't know how to get the different views. Let's see, I'm gonna look up now. That's a little better. All right, so what I want to do is turn my fuel pump on. I want to hold the starter down for 2 seconds. Ignition is on. I should be coming up. And my NG is at 16%, so I can bring this up. And go to come on over. I want to bring it over here, but it doesn't want to move. Is there a button? Well, I got a good start. Let's see. So I can see. All right. That should be the go around. Why won't it move over? Okay, well, we'll figure that out in a minute. All right. So let's go back up here. And autopilot goes on, auto fuel, fuel go to auto, fuel pump go to auto. Don't have to worry about ignition. Generator go to main, and I didn't turn on my lights to start, but we'll turn them on now. And I was gonna say, looks like my landing lights are on, but maybe not. I guess they were, huh? So that's good, because that means I gave somebody some warning that I was gonna start up. And that's actually my taxi light landing. Okay, that's taxi, and that's, huh. So the alpha yoke is not working in the way it should, but that's okay. All right, so let's turn on our inertial separator and let's see if we can't get these pitot heaters on. And we can't, let's see, part brake, pitot heat left and right, auxiliary fuel pump. Let's see, so maybe I turned that on accidentally. Maybe I need to turn it on. Okay. So maybe it should be in this middle position, you think? All right, so let's look and see. Okay, so my auxiliary fuel pump went away. Low voltage. Let's see, what else do I have on here? Do I have anything about auxiliary? No, the auxiliary is on. I need to, well, maybe we should just turn it off, maybe. But I'm pretty sure that that top position should say auto, which is where it should be. But we'll just turn it off. Well, maybe it don't like off either. Okay, yeah, it does like off. Technically, it should be on auto. In flight. All right. So initial separator, pitot heaters, bleeds. Go to auto. All right. And low voltage. That would be, let's see. And I'm pretty sure that should be on main. Let's take a look's peek. Arganda. And probably just want me to, I'm not sure, shouldn't have to. This is not, shouldn't have to rev the engine to get the proper voltage. I bet it's this condition level. Fuel pressure. Come on. So, doesn't look like I'm going to be able to take a flight in this guy. Because I don't know how to. Don't know how to get the condition level to go where I want it to go. This is this is unfortunate, and that's par for the course with this simulator for me. I should be able to, well, I may be conflating it with the TBM900 from X-Plane, where I can just grab this thing and move it over to the, okay. So that's odd. By using the prop, I was able to get it over, which I'm sure shouldn't be the case. At least I'm not sure, but I didn't think it would be the case. But anyway, gonna be able to make this flight after all. Okay, so let's climb up to what, we're not going to do an ATC step climb. We're going to climb on up to whatever we want. Let's make it, 19. East is odd, so let's make it 20, which is pretty high for a short flight. But may not be able to get there. So we've got 100 nautical miles. Actually, for 100 nautical miles, we don't need 20. East is odd, so let's do 16. All right, and let's do a speed of, let's do a climb, and this is the TBM, so we can get a good climb rate. So let's get a climb rate of 19, and we'll figure out a vertical speed a little bit later. Okay, and with our yaw damper, just want to know where it's at, and our autopilot engaged. Okay, I see it. All right, and let's get started here. So we go to ATC. And clearance delivery. Yeah, we can let clearance delivery put in our squat code. I hope it'll do it. Not clearance delivery, but this ATC thing. Okay. Do I do ground services first? Nope. That clearance requests IFR clearance for instrument flight plan.
Raleigh clearance delivery landmark 1123 IFR to Charlotte, ready to copy.
What, 2371? All right. 23 right as filed. Climb initially to 11,000. Departure on 125.3. And then I did get the squat wrong. It's 6371. All right. So let me read that back. And I really would have liked 23 left. Wonder if I can get that. Let's see, ground service. I guess I can't. All right, we do need to get an ATOS, which I should have got before. Anyway, we get it now.
Temperature 28, dew point 10.
Okay, so winds are 249 at 1-2. Squawk altimeter is 3015, and 23 left and right is in use. All right, so let's get this barometer set. And there we go. Something's going right. 1-5. Okay, so our barometers are set, and I guess we can tune to, we can request the taxi, and they're going to give me some taxi instructions that the taxi designations does not match the real airport. Papa Golf Hotel Foxtrot Delta.
Taxi to and hold short runway 23 right using taxiway Papa Golf Hotel Foxtrot Delta landmark 1123.
Okay, so the question is at this point. All right, so I'm good. The taxi now. And let's see, taxi light is on. Pulse is off, strobes are on, so strobes can go off. Strobes are off, okay. That's the nav is on, all right. So I'm gonna turn the navs on and the strobes off for taxi. And let's go ahead and get a taxi started. So let's find a brake. Hold the brake, turn this guy, brakes are off, and she will not taxi in this sim, so I don't have to worry about holding the brake. All right, so I'm looking for Papa, and what I was gonna say is maybe I can treat this like an unfamiliar airport if my designations are correct. Let's see. Okay, so that's working right. All right, I see a yellow brick road up there. And clear right, clear left. Come on. Yeah, this hat, me and this hat button ain't having it. Okay. I missed the yellow brick road looking, trying to clear. But it's all good. Okay, so I'm looking for Papa. And I'm not sure that, let's see. So they want me to do Papa Golf, and let's see, let's go here to the MD. Yeah, that's it, and then let's go to range. And so I am going over here. So, let's see. Actually, yeah. 23 right is gonna be over here. And I'm just gonna go the way that I think I should be going. Might be wrong. Hopefully it's right. Okay, so with any luck, this would be Papa. I wish I could back this guy out a little bit. Now, historically, this taxiway and cause me a crash if I don't negotiate it just right. See how this terrain mesh is kind of funky. That's why I wanted two. That's one of the reasons why I wanted 2-3 left. All right, so. There we go. We got through that hurdle. I think there's one more hurdle to get through, and that's the bridge. Let's see. Yeah, all right. And I think I can cross that bridge. Sure that I don't have a prop strike coming down. Okay, let's see if we can get over this situation here. Might need to get in the grass. I don't know what works. What's gonna work best? Real slow here. Take it real slow. Hit them brakes. And give it some power to get up over this hill. And yep, okay, good guys, we have successfully navigated a really tough taxiway. All right, and I want to clear this turn, but my hat button doesn't want me to look that way. Hurry. So so all right, let's go ahead and put in flaps to take off. All right, and let's check our trims. Look, they look okay. Okay. So the only thing that my cast look okay. Like I said, I can't seem to do anything with these. Buttons. All right, so it's a run-up area, and let's see. So range. I want to be able to see. Okay, let's see if we can't clear to the left. Well, let's just hope and pray. I'm laughing because, you know, this is a multi-million-dollar aircraft, and we're going to hope and pray, right? All right. So, go to ATC. And I guess we can tune the tower. And get up a little closer to a whole short. Two, three, right. All right.
Raleigh Tower landmark 1123 ready for IFR departure runway 23 right.
Landmark 1123 altimeter 0.15.249er at 12. Traffic is generic on final. Cleared for takeoff runway 23 right.
No delay. Take off runway 23 right, landmark 1123.
No delay. TBM, I guess we'll rotate at 80. Rotate. Over rotate it there. Alright, positive rate. Tap the brake, gear up. Runway heading. And we clear to 11,000.
Landmark 1123, contact Raleigh departure on 125.3.
Going to 125.3 landmark 1123.
For the gables. All right.
Raleigh departure landmark 1123 is passing 2,300 feet, climbing 11,000 feet.
Landmark 1123, Raleigh departure altimeter 0.15, continue to Sierra Delta Zulu as planned.
Okay, so as planned, so that means I can go with nav. Y'all damper can come on. Autopilot. And So the number down here in the lower right-hand corner of the screen in yellow is my frame per second. And every now and then you'll see that dip down to about 4, and it'll come back up. I'm not sure what's going on when that happens. Okay, so I'm definitely don't feel like I'm on a flight plan now. Let me see. Flying in circles here. So autopilot. Okay. Nav. Got my climb rate, so I'm climbing. So it says ROV. So I'm not. Yeah. Let's see. I bet I don't have a flight plan then. Back. Flight plan. Okay. There's my line. Maybe it's just me. Okay, so okay, so I'm not sure what I'm doing here, but this is me, and I don't see magenta. Yep, see, that's definitely not working. And all right, so let's go direct here. Let's try this. Insert before, let's see, back, direct to, activate. All right. Let's see if that fixes it.
Landmark,
whatever I am. All right, so I need to acknowledge that.
135.2 landmark 1123.
And as you can see, autopilot's just not working. So we're gonna have to just give it a head. And when it comes back around, then we'll look for the heading that we want. Or bearing 2, well, maybe this is the problem. Maybe we just don't have the right 2. Okay, so I'm at altitude and I haven't even got out of the 5 mile range out of the Charlie. All right, Washington Center.
Washington Center landmark 1123, 11,100 feet.
Landmark 1123, Washington Center altimeter 30.1
out to and vertical up. See, flaps, did I raise my flaps? Nope, still in takeoff. My gear did come up. Landing lights can go off. Landing and taxi lights. Not working correctly, so I'm just gonna have to burn those taxi lights. Not a whole lot I can do about that. All right, so let me course correct here for on my head. So without my autopilot working the way that I want it to work, I'm not sure I really want to fly this flight. And it could be something okay. So this is probably the problem here. I'm flying a VOR nav, and now that I just put that to GPS, so that might fix my issue. And I'm just now getting over Jordan Lake. Okay, but I think that will fix my issue. All right, so okay, so live and learn. Pilot error. All right. So now I should be able to look out the window, see what I see down there at 14,000. And 3015, yep, got that set in now. All right, so. So 210 with a 2-knot headwind. My inertia separator can come off.
Landmark 1123, please expedite your climb 14,000 feet.
Ah, come on. So let's try adjusting the barometer. Okay.
Descend and maintain 5,000 feet. Keep speed not above 210 knots. Expect ILS runway 23 left approach via 21
All right, so that didn't work. So let's, it's still asking me to get up to 14. And I was hoping if I can. So let's change the. So I'm seeing 14.1 on, yeah, see this is, well, maybe that did it. All right, we've got some traffic. Traffic. Now I'm sitting here, so I'm looking for that guy and don't see him. All right, so let's set this to 14. So he would be below me. And I don't see him, can't really look out the window. So maybe he seen. Maybe he see me at 14,000 now, even though I'm showing 14,250. And wonder if I can get a ATCA barometer check. Let's see if it'll let me do that. Request vector. Nope. Hmm. Well, I must have hadn't heard him ask me to ascend to climb the 14,000 in a while, so maybe I'm finally at altitude. I'm approaching my waypoint and Sierra Delta Zulu is Sand Hills. And there's a golf course, oh man. Alright, so I'm seeing traffic that I should turn towards in just a minute. I'm expecting him to advise me on that traffic. And I don't see him. Apparently he's either high enough or low enough where he's not a factor. Okay, so I'm over the ground at 287 knots, ETA, 14 minutes.
One three three dot 15.
133.15 landmark 1123. Atlanta Center landmark 1123 is passing 12,900 feet, descending 6,000 feet.
Landmark 1123 Atlanta Center altimeter 30.17.
So what I'm going to do is a direct to JEP.
MSFS. I need to go up here and Julia Echo Papa Hotel Sierra. All right, so I'm gonna do a direct to there. Direct to waypoint. And turn off the, all right, direct. So direct to waypoint. And so I'm not sure. Whoa, what happened? I didn't hear my autopilot disengage. Yeah. Did the autopilot stop working or something? Or did I get too slow? Autopilot. This flight, oh, look at the descent. Don't sink. Don't sink. Now you see how the autopilot just kind of went crazy. I'm not sure what happened. And quite honestly, I don't know if it was me or the autopilot. So to go. We looking for 2-3 right, I mean 2-3, which if tell you something else that happened.
Going to 128.325
landmark 1123. Actually, that one did not catch my attention. I'm not sure whether or not I've got Jeffers in the direct to well, maybe that's it. I don't know, but it won't let me. Can't seem to add or change a waypoint. All right, let's hit the now button and see what happens. So I am flying nav now. But it don't. Heading. Let's go back to heading. And I want to do a direct to. Direct to there we go. JEP Hotel Sierra. Enter. Activate. All right. Nav. Real. Took me a while to figure out how to get a direct to in the GPS. Let me go out, see how close I am to the airport graphically. Back. Now,
Charlotte approach landmark 1123 requesting vendor to next waypoint.
Landmark 1123 continues to take EVA left turn and following heading 325.
Continue to just turning and following heading 325 landmark 1123.
So it looks like it's going to take me
all the way up to wherever it's taking me. It's like it's gonna be really out of the way. Which would make sense if I was doing 1.8, but since it's got me expecting 2.3, then if I'd have stayed on this course, then anyway, let's go back out and see what happens. So I'm not getting any information from my all right, let's look at the flight plan. I tell you what I'm gonna do, let's see if I can get in an approach for 2.3 back. All right, procedure, approach, and transition. I can't even read that. Okay, 2.3 is what I want. I want to screw this down. For 2.3, load, and then do the flight plan. Go direct to Charlotte, because I don't know what else to do. All right, Charlotte. Ooh.
log to waypoint. How do I get direct to? Okay, activate. So I'm at 4,000. It sent me to J part. And all right. I take a little bit more speed. We'll be happy with about 180, 185, 190. Just see what this says if I ask for a vector to the next
one. Charlotte approach landmark 1123 requesting vector to next
I'm just going to stay on my present course. It's close enough to 265. Okay, so if I'm going to do a localizer, then once I get established, I think I'm going to have to switch to loc. All right. And let me try putting the all tail in here. Direct to. So direct to Charlotte. And direct to add in row waypoint ALLAT backspace ATL. ATELL. Okay. Enter. And of course, it's going to be the closest one. And then hit done. Done. Direct to. That's 4 miles out. Destination. Okay. Charlotte. Is it ALT or TL? ALT.
Yeah.
down on the approach. And I was 14 miles out from Gordon Call Tower. Man, I would get clouds where I can't see the airport. Alright, so. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and hit this approach button. And see if that put me on VOR2. And so I guess excuse me guys, but I completely, this is, How am I looking on fuel? Fuel quantity is okay. And now I am okay, direct, okay. So I got information here and information here. Okay. My inertial separators are on. So there's something that I'm missing, but that's okay, because I may just cancel. Well, now I got to go to 6,300 just to show them that I'm at 6,000. All right, so
Charlotte approach landmark 1123 would like to cancel IFR.
Landmark 1123 IFR flight plan is canceled, radar service terminated. Squawk 1200. Maintain VFR. Frequency change approved. Good day.
Charlotte approach landmark 1123
is 230. I'm gonna have to do a 360. My 360 now. Maintain my speed and watch that speed. Stormy at Charlotte. I would love to be the bat taxi. Planning on it. So I'm gonna park down here, so I'm gonna turn to the turn to the left here. Landing on it.
Now,
I can't read the signs. So
now here's the sign I can read. So I want Alpha 4, and then Golf. Charlie, and then Charlie 8. All right, so that's the wrong way. Sure that I should make a right here. That's Charlie 9. It's Charlie 8. Or maybe this is Charlie 8. And now I'm going to take Charlie 9 because that should put me right at the FBO that I'll be parking. Don't know what this is, but I'm taking it. See one of those guys waving me from anywhere. Big plane to be a general aviation. Frames per second. That's pretty low. But you're gonna pop right in here and park, right? In spite of everything. And let's get to go in here for 2 or 3 seconds. I'll to bring that this way. And it's not going over. So lead air can come off. And can't get this to go over. There we go. I'm done. Yep, I'm done. All right, so I guess I could. Don't work. All right. So yeah. All right, guys. It's been an interesting flight. So I am able to complete a flight now. I have tried to complete this flight several times with Microsoft Flight Simulator, and this is only about the second or the third time that I have been able to complete the flight. So that tells me that the simulator is getting better, even though I still had there still are some technical glitches. Given that this is the one of the default aircraft, you would think that these aircraft would work perfectly within their parameters. The stuff that's modeled would work the way it should, but that's not the case. Anyway, until I'm just not comfortable using the G3000, until I can figure out a way to be able to manipulate it, and all the while looking out the window, anyway, I guess it just takes some getting used to, as do anything new. Anyway, so I hope you enjoyed the flight, and until next time.
Don't come back now. Here.